Hello friends, in this video I'll be helping with alpha and beta testing. So let's start. So first question comes is why we do alpha or beta testing. The reason is that we want to be fully ensured that our product is ready for deployment in the market, and also it does not contain any defect. And the reason is that you as a developer work on a professional level, right? And if your software is containing any defects or loophole and you released it in the real-time environment or in the market, then it can cause huge loss to the company and as well as you. Why? So because you are the developer of that software, right? So that is why the developer wants to be fully confident, or you can say fully ensured, before launching the product in the real-time environment. So let's start with what is alpha testing, and then I'll be coming to beta testing as well. So in alpha testing, what we do is we try to take out or detect all the possible issues, bugs or defects before releasing the product in the real-time environment, or you can say to the everyday users or the public. Okay, so we keep the product secret or away from the end users, and we try to take out the defects. So for taking out defects, you can use both techniques, that is black box testing technique as well as white box testing technique. So now the aim, what is the aim of the alpha testing? The aim of the alpha testing is to test the particular software for typical user tasks. Okay, because you can't test the software for all the users when the software is very very big, because unlimited number of inputs are possible, right, to a particular software. So what you do is you test for typical users, and it is carried out in lab environment, and sometimes it is also carried out by the internal employees of organization. Why? So because if it contains any defects also, then it will not cause any damage to the end users. And what big companies like Google and Mac and sorry Apple and other companies do is, before they release the software in the real-time environment, they give the software to the internal organization, or you can say internal employees of the organization, to test and give feedback to the company. And upon getting feedback, they do changes to the product, and then they do beta testing of the product as well, and then they release it. So what happens is the released product is of very very high quality, and as well as it is defect free as well. So this kind of testing is called as alpha testing because it is done first, or you can say before beta testing. That's why it is named as alpha testing. And next is beta testing. So in beta testing, what we do is we say the end users that okay, we are providing you the software, or you can say the product, but we can't ensure that this software is not containing any defects or any bugs. You use the software and you tell us if you encounter any bug or defect in the software, and we'll try to update that, or if you feel any feature can be updated or not. So the particular product is not released, it is just provided to the end users for reporting of any bugs or any changes or any feature that can be added, so that the software could be updated accordingly. So that is why it is also termed as external user acceptance testing, because it involves real end users who will be using that. And it is released to a limited number of end users to obtain feedback on product quality, as I told you, to get a real feedback from the real users. So this was all. So please do consider liking and subscribing. So thanks for watching.